senses help different species navigate their world. But some animals have incredible extra senses, including dolphins. This is the Dolphin Research Center in Grassy Key, in the heart of the Keys, a chain of tropical islands off Florida's southernmost tip. The dolphins here look like they're having fun, and they do play all day. But it's play with a purpose. Researchers at the center are studying dolphin behavior and intelligence. The dolphins are mostly in it for the fish. But these playful mammals do also enjoy attention. And they're as vocal as their trainers in their excitement. While most humans vocalize primarily through the air, aquatic mammals do most of theirs underwater. It turns out that's how dolphins manage some of their best tricks. It's called echolocation. Dolphins send out sounds and pick up the echoes of those sounds to locate things. This dolphin is going to find a ring tossed underwater while blindfolded. These are eye cups. They cover the dolphin's eyes, but come off easily if he blinks. Being playful, he returns them when they fall off. For him, that's part of the game. Before his trainer puts the eye cups on, she shows him a ring. He's familiar with it by sight and touch. He stores the mental picture in his brain. Now, she puts his eye cups on and sends him out to find it. After searching around a little while, he finds the ring and brings it back without the use of sight. Not a problem for a dolphin with a keen sense of hearing. The ring doesn't make a sound on its own, but sounds can bounce off the ring. Dolphins improve their chances of sounds bouncing off objects by making sounds themselves. Little clicks. They can be heard above the water's surface, too. They create the sounds using structures inside their nasal cavities, beneath the blowhole. They're called phonic lips. Every dolphin has two pairs of phonic lips, so they can make two clicks at the same time. The clicks are short, measured in microseconds. But they can make them in a constant series called a click train. Some clicks are at such high frequencies, human ears can't pick them up. People only hear dolphin clicks at the lower frequency of 20 kilohertz or less. But dolphins send out their clicks at frequencies of up to 120 kilohertz. Even dogs, known for picking up high-pitched sounds, can't hear that. So these dolphins are swimming effortlessly, but not soundlessly, through the deep ocean. It's one of the ways they find each other. The outgoing sounds they produce with their phonic lips are amplified as they pass through the bump on the dolphin's head. It's a fatty structure called the melon. When the beam of sound encounters an object, like a potential meal or another dolphin, it bounces back, coming in through the mandible. And the dolphin decodes the echoes to tell what is out there. It's a fast process. Sound travels four times as fast in the water as it does in the air. So if a target is close, the dolphin gets a mental picture in real time with only a slight sound delay. That mental picture includes a sense of how a target is moving and where. Since sound intensity decreases over distance, some of the sound waves that bounce back to the dolphins are very soft. Dolphins' ears have evolved accordingly and are some of the best of any animal. These dolphins can demonstrate this too. His trainer is asking him to copy whatever moves his fellow dolphin makes. Once again, he's blindfolded. That means the best way to figure out what tricks the other dolphin is doing is by hearing what the other dolphin does. Time after time, he gets it right. It's a super sense of hearing. It's well worth celebrating. Echolocation is a useful super sense for another species. These lesser funnel-eared bats are found in the dry caves of the Bahamas. They possess some enchanting natural powers. Not only are they the world's only flying mammal, but they can hunt with deadly efficiency in the pitch black of night. There are about 900 species of bat, and over half of them use sound to navigate or echolocate. Like dolphins, bats make a sound, the sound bounces off objects around it, and back to the bat. Sounds simple, but how this actually happens is anything but. For a bat to see with sound, it has to make a sound called a chirp. Trouble is, for some bats, that chirp is as loud as 120 decibels. That's rock concert volume. It's in the ultrasonic frequency range, which means humans can't hear it. But the bats can, and that decibel level is loud enough to do serious damage to their ears. Luckily, they've adapted the incredible ability to essentially switch off their ears for just long enough to save them from harm. 6 milliseconds before the larynx muscles contract to blast out that sound, the middle ear bones separate, and their hearing sensitivity is reduced. 2 to 8 milliseconds later, the middle ear muscles relax and become sensitive again, just in time to receive the much quieter echo. Bats won't chirp again until the echo returns, so as not to confuse themselves. The echo of an insect 1 meter away would take 6 milliseconds to return. Having so much happen in such a short amount of time seems just plain batty. But it's the only way echolocation can work. The initial chirp has to be that loud because it immediately starts losing power density. When it hits an object and bounces back, it loses even more density. By the time the echo is heard by the bat, it can be thousands of times quieter than the original chirp. The bat's ears are sensitive enough to hear this. Even so, that's still not a lot of info to work with. But the bat recalculates this information hundreds of times per second, creating a highly detailed picture of its surroundings. As bats fly towards their prey, they chirp at an accelerating rate, faster and faster, until the echolocation calls reach mind-boggling levels. And the prey is caught. 160 to 190 chirps per second. The bat's larynx can contract up to 200 times per second, and the ear bones contract and relax for every single chirp. This super sense is what makes bats the most prolific night hunters the world has ever seen.